Okay, today we're gonna put some new brakes on the Wabash. I think I bought this trailer in September, October, and they look bad then, but they're not bad enough to really change, but they've bothered me, so I'm just gonna go ahead and change them and take you along for the ride. So I've changed this one. I've got that one finished already, so there's what's left. Three brake kits and three new drums. I just decided to do the whole thing, and I'll do a little breakdown on what it costs to actually do it yourself, and maybe somebody that's doesn't really know how to do it, this video is super easy to do, and I'll show you what it actually costs if you do it yourself. It's pretty cheap. Say they're not completely worn out, but they're all but. So this one will be a little easier because it's not. Let's see what you can see here. You can see right here, you got two rollers, one here and one there, and that's what that S cam, as you apply brake, that's what rolls and that's what expands the shoes. So I just take a tire tool and hopefully not hit you and fall off. Oh, that's right. They've got some kind of wire holding them in. Well, these are the same as the last one. Come on, baby. Down. I did the same thing to the bottom one. Normally you can just pull them out of there. Those little straps, I kind of got them in there good. Let's take a little bar, pry them out. There you go. Now there's a spring. There's a spring that's what holds the brake down. So you just go down there and lift it off. There you go. Then all you gotta do is take the top one, just pry it right up, and the whole thing will come off. Easy. I'm gonna get a screwdriver and clean that S cam up a little bit. That old grease. We got new brake shoes, and when you get new brake shoes, they always come with new hardware. There we go. Alright. You see on these old ones, this pin right here, and that, you get new ones of those, but they're not installed. That's for the main spring brake to go. So, here's your new brake shoes, and the big end right here will go along the pivot. So where we need to drive that pin is right here. put it in there just right, and then kind of hit this way, or whichever way, you know. Here we go. Make sure that it's clean. Oh, so these pivot pins come with new bushings, but the old ones look fine, so I'm not going to mess with it. So we'll put our two pivot pins in there. They're nice and tight. Actually, one of these, I kind of got to give it a little tappy, tap, 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 roo. There it went right in. So what I found about this job is it can be a hard job if you don't know just a few little tricks. And I'll show you one right here that got me the first time I ever put brakes on something. Even though you just don't know. It had been a long time. Oh, our little springs here. Oh, you guys probably can't see that. Let me move you. Okay, there we go. So we got our brake drum on there. We got our brake shoe on there. So what we need to do is take our little springs, just hang them off. That one's not down enough for some reason. There it goes. Just like so. Hang one there. And hang one on the back. And here's a little tip I was going to show you. So when you got this like this, where you start on the pivot side. You got your spring right here and it won't reach. They go, oh, come on! And these things are stiff. So it's kind of counterintuitive, I guess. But you go even farther. Oh, I'm trying to make it where you guys can see. You raise it up. Oh, come on. And they'll go right in. Woo! Oh, come on. Get our big spring in here. So kind of make gravity work with it. This is another thing that I struggled with for a long time until I figured it out. These little pins are going to want to hang down no matter what. So hook the bottom one first. We got it hooked. Okay, they're still hooked. Yep. Yeah. There we go. Would you guys believe that's the hardest one that's on camera? Take our new rollers, our safety wire, and let me see, I want this one to be in. So there we go. Hopefully I can pry without the clamp. I gotta get my leg under it. You guys
just hit the bean garden for that. Here we go. See, I put that roller in there. And we take our safety wire. There we go. Now so we can get the brake drum on there, I'm going to back this. You can probably watch this S-cam move. It's going to come in like this, like clockwise.
Compete with you, Jolene. talks about a shoe in his sleeve, and there was nothing I can do to keep from crying when he called your name, Jolene. Understand how you could easily